Welcome back to a new video. So we are discussing the chemical equations and reactions of the chemistry chapter, which is part 2. If you did not saw my part 1, I'll drop it in my description box. So in this video we are going to learn what are the characteristics of chemical reaction, what are remaining we have, that is change in temperature, change in color, change in physical state, what is chemical equation based and what are its types, means based on writing, based on balancing. Based on writing we have two types, that is word equation and symbolic equation. Based on balancing we have two types again, that is balanced equation and unbalanced equation. So first is this topic, that is change in temperature. So change in temperature can be denoted in two types, which is endothermic reaction or exothermic. Thermic reaction. So in what is endothermic? Endothermic means in a chemical reaction the heat energy is required. In exothermic the heat energy is released, okay? Heat energy is released in exothermic. Released. Heat energy is needed. Okay. Right? Next one. Coming to the second point, that is change in color. So change in color means in a chemical reaction, the reactant sites, one compound which is colored compound will changes due to the chemical reaction to colorless compound or any other color except the color which is in the reactants initially. So what are the examples? So let us discuss now. Examples of this equation is this is Zn plus FeSO4 gives rise to ZnSO4 plus Cu. Fe. So what is the change? How this equation is related to change in color? Now this FeSO4 which is in green color crystalline form, green color crystals, okay, due to the displacement reaction it changes into the zinc sulfate which is colorless compound. I will give you one more example, which is Fe plus CuSO4 gives rise to FeSO4 plus Cu. You know that FeSO4 is a green color compound. And CuSO4 is a blue color compound. So due to the displacement reaction or a chemical equation, the blue color compound changes into the green color. So this topic also completed, change in color. Now change in physical state means the physical states are three types, as you know, solids, liquids and gases. So how they are changed, let us know with the example. So now example of the third one example. So first example, let's take water decomposition. Decomposition water forms, which is a liquid. Water is a liquid, as you know. It after decomposition it forms into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So gas and liquid. So liquid is decomposed into form gas. So it is a change in physical state, which is a characteristic of chemical reaction. Second one,
decomposition gives us to CaO plus O2. So this is a solid which is limestone, or it's also called as calcium carbonate, which on decomposition to form a solid and a gas. So here also the gas is formed, so it is also in the indication of changing physical state. Now what is a chemical equation? So that is main, because in the chapter literally chemical reaction and equations are present. So what is chemical equation? Let us learn. Chemical equations are shorthand representation of chemical reaction. The definition is shorthand representation of chemical reaction. What is this R into X means? This shortcut method of reaction. Okay, right. So they are again divided into two topics, that is based on writing and based on balancing. So based on writing, word equation and symbol equation. So based on writing, what is word equation? Word equation, as the name suggests, word equation means in a chemical reaction everything is written in words. Means let us take one example. Hydrogen plus oxygen to form water. Okay, or this is not a suitable reaction, you can also take one more thing. Carbon plus oxygen gives rise to carbon dioxide. Okay, or you can also give as calcium carbonate decomposes to form calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide gas. Right, these are all are in words, right? Everything is in words, right? Everything is words in this both equations. Everything in is word. Everything is in words, is in words. So it's called as word equation. So what is symbolic equation? These word equations are changes into the symbols. So this carbon plus oxygen gives rise to carbon dioxide, will write in symbolic equation. Symbolic equation means it, the reaction, it changes into symbols. Okay, so carbon means C, as you know, C plus O2, which is oxygen, is present in O2 state. So CO2, which is a symbolic equation. Yes or not? So how you know that CO2 is only the formula of the reaction between carbon and oxygen? Because due to its valency, as C has +4 and O has -2 valency, it got crisscross method, and C2O4 and one time and two times, so it forms CO2 compound. Okay, right. Next one. What is next example? Let's take one more example. Hydrogen plus chlorine gives rise to hydrochloric acid or hydrogen chloride, which is a gas. Right, Now let us change this word equation into the symbolic equation. So hydrogen is also present in gas state, which is used in fuels, and Cl2 also present in the gaseous state, so it forms HCl. So how it forms HCl? Again, valency is only the correct. So H has one valency and Cl has one valency. Due to crisscross method of this, H1 and Cl1, so one is not countable, so we'll get HCl only the answer. Okay, there are millions of examples. Okay, let me give you a one compound written example. Let's take calcium carbonate. I already said its formula is CaCO3. How it is CaCO3? Again, valency is only valency, or ionic compound, also ionic concept, both can know the formula of a compound, chemical formula of a compound. Ca has plus 2 ion and CO3 has minus 2 ion. To the crisscross method, Ca2 and CO3 taken twice will be there. You cannot write this minus and plus in the cross multiplication method. This is you have to remember. Now this and this gets cancelled, so you get CaCO3, which is a correct verification method, right? So we have completed the first one, that is based on writing both one. What is that? Word equation and symbolic equation based on writing, balanced equation and unbalanced equation. What is balanced equation? Let us learn. So balanced equation, as the name suggests, it is balanced, okay, or it is also called as stoichiometric equation. So in a chemical reaction, the total number of atoms present on the reactants is equal to the total atoms present on the product side. Okay, this is the definition. Means, example, NaOH plus HCl gives rise to NaCl plus H2O, which is a neutralization reaction. Base plus acid gives rise to salt and water, which is a neutralization reaction. We know that. So this is balanced equation, okay? Now unbalanced equation. So unbalanced equation is opposite of balanced equation. Just you should keep that in a chemical reaction, the total number of atoms present on the reactants is not equal to the total atoms present in the product side. So it is unbalanced equation. I'll give you a small example towards it. So H2O gives, on decomposition, gives rise to H2 plus O2. Okay, so thank you for watching this video, and please don't forget to subscribe.